praise the Lord on tonight, Troy. This is the first night of our holy convocation, and we came to be set apart. We came to just center our minds on the Lord so that we can have an ear to hear what the Spirit is telling us to do on tonight. So for these next 10 nights, we want you to come with an open heart and open mind. Come with the spirit of expectancy, saying that, God, I'm not going to be the same way that I came in. But before we get a word from the Lord, we have to bless him. We have to bless the Lord for waking us up. Bless the Lord for allowing us to travel here safely. Bless the Lord simply for who he is. Truly, he is a God that does not change. He's the same today and forevermore. So whatever you stand in need of on tonight, we know that God has it for each and every one of you. If it's just a spiritual growth in the Lord, truly, we know that when we seek God first, everything else falls into place. So this week alone, we need to ask God to allow us to grow in him. And once you grow in God, everything else will be all right. So just help us bless the Lord. If you want to bless the Lord tonight, if you come to bless the Lord tonight, put your hands together if you came to bless him.
Come on, bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Oh, bless the Lord with me. Everybody sing, bless the Lord with me.
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 Oh, bless the Lord with me.
Come on and clap your hands with me, come on and clap your hands with me, come on and clap your hands with me, oh, clap your hands with me.
Let me see you clap your hands tonight.
Clap your hands with me.
Oh, you want to put your hands up?
Clap your hands with me.
Clap your hands with me.
Clap your hands with me.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, raise your hands with me. Yes. Come on, raise your hands with me. Come on and wave your hands with me. Oh, wave your hands with me.
Wave your hands with me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you want to give God a wave offering on tonight?
Wave your hands with me.
Wave your hands with me.
Wave your hands with me.
Oh,
wave your hands with me.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Oh, bless the Lord with me.
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 Did you come to bless the Lord?
The Lord with me.
What is the highest word?
Hallelujah.
What
We sing, oh, hallelujah.
What
is the highest praise? What is the highest praise?
Hallelujah.
What is the highest praise?
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, he
reigns.
He reigns.
He reigns.
He reigns. He reigns.
He reigns.
He reigns.
He reigns.
Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Oh, bless the Lord with me. Everybody sing, bless the Lord with me.
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 Truly came to bless the Lord on tonight. Truly, I came to bless the Lord with everything that I have, everything that is within me on tonight. Truly, I will bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name on tonight. Truly, we will bow our heads and pray. Lord God, we thank you tonight. For grace, God, we thank you. For mercy, God, we thank you for allowing us to be able to come into your house, God, to bless your name, God, to give you praise, to give you glory, and to give you honor on tonight, God. We ask that you would just continue to stir up each and every one of our gifts on tonight. We ask that you would just continue to hold us up these next 10 nights, God. We thank you right now for your strength. We thank you for your power. God, we thank you for the word of God that we're going to receive in this building on tonight, God. Truly, where there is praying and praising in the pews, there will be preaching in the pulpit. So, God, give the speaker of the hour a word to stir up each and every one of our hearts and our spirits. Allow us to have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church, God. We thank you right now for this service. We thank you right now for growth. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Truly, our theme tonight is to simply bless the Lord. How many came to bless him? Truly, blessing God is a verb. It is doing something. It requires you to open up your mouth. It requires you to wave your hands. It requires you to act on tonight. So if you came to be lazy on the night, oh, just forget about that, because we came to bless him. Did you come to help us bless God? Did you come to help us bless him? Put your hands together.
I will bless the Lord at all times. He's good.
Oh, I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. He's good.
I will bless the Lord at all times. He's good.
He is good.
He is good.
So good.
So good.
We the Lord at all times. He's good.
Oh, I will bless.
I will bless the Lord at all times. He's good.
Oh, did you come to bless?
I will bless the Lord at all times. He's good.
All time.
I will bless the Lord at all.
will bless.
I will bless the Lord.
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 Bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. He's good.
Yeah. How many will truly bless the Lord on tonight at all times? For truly is good. God is good all the time on tonight. And all the time, the Lord is truly good. Despite of what you've done, despite of what it looks like, despite of what the devil continues to try to throw in your path, God is still good. God still makes ways out of no way, truly. God still turns situations around in our lives. Why? He is working on our behalf. We have to continue to bless him with our hands lifted up. We have to bless him with our mouth full of praise. We have to bless God with everything that we have on tonight. We can't say it more than enough on tonight. We truly came to bless the Lord. Have you thought about what God is doing in your life? Have you thought about the things you want God to do for you? Have you thought about the ways that God makes in your life on tonight? Truly, he owes our praise. We owe him our worship. We owe him our gratitude on tonight. Truly, we came to bless God with everything, not just words, not just with the fruits of our lips, but we came to bless the Lord with our hands, with our feet, and with our mouths. We will bless the Lord. So as we worship with God on this last song of tonight, give him everything that you have. Because truly, somebody didn't wake up on this morning. And if they woke up, they were not in their right minds. Somebody wasn't able to come out on tonight because they didn't feel well in their bodies. But on tonight, you were able to come in the house. And for that reason, I will bless them. Do you owe God anything on tonight? It's not just me telling you you owe God, but do you actually believe it in your heart and know it in your spirit that you owe God a praise on tonight with a heart of thanksgiving? I will bless the Lord on tonight. So just worship with us as we sing this last song on tonight. I will bless.
I will bless the Lord. I will bless thee.
truly, I will bless the Lord. I will give God my praise. I will give God my whole heart, my body, my mind, my soul, everything that encompasses me on tonight. I will give it to the Lord. Truly, I owe God, for truly my body is the temple of the Holy Ghost on tonight, and we are housing the Spirit of the Lord on tonight. And those that worship God must worship Him in spirit and truth. Those that bless God must bless God with a pure heart, a pure mind on tonight. Truly, I came to give God everything that is within me on tonight. Truly, I was listening to a song on today, and it said, today is your day. Today is my day, and you don't have to be the same. So wherever you are right now in your life, you do not have to be the same. You can be changed. You can be made over. You can be free on tonight. As Bishop has been telling us, truly, we want God to be our personal Savior, not just someone that continues to forgive us over and over and over again. How many knows that once He saves you and He pulls you out of the muck and the mud, you can't live this life without. You can't bless the Lord. You can't give Him your body, your mind, and your soul on tonight. How many came ready for a word from the Lord on tonight? How many came ready with an open heart, with a mind and ears to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church on tonight? Truly, if you have your electronic devices on tonight, truly, if you're on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, whatever medium you use on tonight, we want you to check in that you're at the Bible Way House of Prayer, that you're getting worship and you're getting word from the Lord on tonight. And as Bishop gives us a word, we want you to just spread the good news of Jesus Christ. If He says something tonight that is going to touch your heart, your mind, and your spirit, we want you to just go and share that good news. Can we get you to do that on tonight? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm ready for the word. Are you ready for the word? And if you're not ready for the word, what's wrong with you? Neighbor, I'm ready for the word. Are you ready for the word? And if you're not ready for the word, what's wrong with you? Put your hands together for the speaker of the hour, Bishop Reginald Bell Senior. Give him a hand as he comes around.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I will bless thee, O Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. I don't know about you, amen, but I come to be blessed. Hallelujah. I come to be blessed. And because I came to be blessed, I'm going to bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't mind blessing the Lord on this evening. Amen. Let's look way to the Lord in the word of prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, dear God, we thank you for being here on tonight. We want to take this time out and thank you for how you have blessed us, enabled us to travel the dangerous highway. You brought us here safely. We thank you for your traveling mercy. And dear God, now that we are here the first night of this convocation, dear God, the gathering of your people, dear God, should be with us. Be in this meeting, Lord. Oh, dear God, like none other, or not this servant have never before. Dear God, send a word. Send a word, dear God, that your people may be able to hear and grow thereby. Bless everyone that show up here on this week. Oh, dear God, bless them in a mighty way. Oh, dear God, reverse some decisions. Oh, dear God, overturn some things. Oh, dear God, show your people where it can be done through your word. Dear God, use us as being one of your servants. Dear God, speak through us. Dear God, we allow us to dismiss and have your way through us. In the name of Jesus. Dear God, bless those that's on their way. Dear God, look upon them. Dear God, those that hadn't decided whether they're going to come or not, touch their mind, dear God. Let them come in before it's too late. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. And thank God. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. If you can. You may be seated. If you can. Amen. God is so good. Amen. He is worthy of all praises. Amen. And I'm just excited about what the Lord is doing. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We sang a praise, amen, that can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Amen? And you got to understand that that is a true save. Amen? God knows how to treat you and I. Amen? Be honest with you, he treats us better than we treat ourselves. And for that, I'm thankful. Amen. Amen. We're just so excited. Amen. On tonight. Amen. Tonight being round number one. Amen. Of the convocation. Our annual convocation. Amen. We're excited about what God is going to be doing. How God is going to bless. Amen. I'm talking about God going to do some great things. I'm expecting him. Amen. The next, amen, amen, 10 nights to do some mighty works. Amen. I'm expecting him to do that. Amen. I am still sanctified. Amen. Still love the Lord. Amen. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. Amen. Thank God for salvation. Praising God, amen, for being filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Somebody said that with a mighty burning fire. Amen. I'm so thankful for that. Amen. Thank you for my lovely wife, Pope Pastor Bell. Amen. I appreciate her. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. My army bearer. Amen. He out. Amen. He under the weather a little bit. And she said to me, you want me to put your iPad up there for you? Amen. 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 I said, oh, that's all right. But thank you, man. Amen. Amen. God is good. Amen. He's a good God. Amen. We're so thankful. Amen. For what the Lord is doing. Amen. How God certainly has been blessing. Amen. Thank God for our verses. Amen. You may be seated on tonight. Amen. Tonight is round number one. Amen. The Lord laid on my heart. Amen. Tonight. Amen. It's going to be sort of like our introduction night. Amen. To perhaps to allow you all to understand or to know, amen, what the itinerary is going to be. Amen. For the next, amen, 9 nights. Amen. Amen. I intend to allow God to have his way. Glory to God. Amen. Speak as God gives me to speak. In the past, perhaps I may have done, amen, all 10 nights. Maybe a time or two. Amen. But in the past, I have used ministers and the deacons, amen, YMD and missionary to speak. And I think we had a great time. Glory to God. Amen. 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 What God laid in my heart, amen, amen, a special message. Amen. He wants to deliver unto his people. Amen. He says to me that, and you are qualified to deliver the message. Glory to God. Amen. Because sometimes you have to wonder what somebody else is going to say. Glory to God. Amen. But when God gives you a word, amen, amen, and yet I am still wondering what God is going to say. Amen. But I know I'm going to obey God. And I'm going to say exactly what God gives me to say. Amen. I'm looking forward to more being here as the week goes on. Amen. Amen. But I thank God for they call you all the faithful few. Amen. Amen. I thank God for you pressing your way. Amen. Amen. I said to someone today, I said, well, it's going to be kind of tight tonight and tomorrow night. Amen. Then we'll kind of get in the rhythm a little bit on Friday night. And then we'll go back in the rut again on Sunday. And then Monday night going to be well. And after that, we're down here. Amen. But God is going to bless. I really believe that the Lord is going to bless. Amen? On this week, amen, amen, we're going to talk on this week, amen, concerning the church, amen, and the church responsibility, amen, or so I say the congregation responsibility, amen, to the leader, amen, the role the church plays in, amen, in care of the leader, amen, amen, we started on it. In Leeds, Alabama, amen, with J.R., amen, just remember, amen, we're going to talk on that a couple of nights, amen, hoping God will let me out of it soon, Amen. But if not, we intend to say what God gives us to say. Amen. And then from that, if we go like I desire, amen, we're going to talk, amen, concerning the responsibility, amen, of the ministers, amen. Amen. And next night, the responsibility of the deacons, amen. Amen. That'd be Monday night, the ministers, and Tuesday night, the deacons, amen. Amen. And Wednesday night, the missionaries, amen. Amen. And Thursday night, amen, we'll be back on the YMV. Amen. And you know, I was trying to find something, amen, on the children, but you know, all that I can remember, I can call this talking to the children, was simply, children, obey your parents. Amen. Obey your parents, that your days may be long. Isn't that something? Amen. Amen. But what we our intent is, amen, to deal with those subjects. Amen. Amen. Our Sister Spencer, Sister Renisha, amen, she took the time out and she made a flyer. Amen. It says, amen. Amen. Keep calm. And then she named a whole lot of different things that, amen, you need to keep calm and do this, keep calm and do that. Amen. And I was telling Co-Pastor, we need to keep calm and listen. Amen. And that's what I want you all to do on this week. Is just keep calm and listen. Amen. Don't get enraged. Don't get upset. Don't allow Satan to creep in and, amen, and behoove you, amen, not to listen to the gospel. Amen. But keep calm. Amen. And have an ear to hear, amen, what the Spirit is saying to the church. Now, don't even go there by saying, well, I'm not a minister, so I'm not going to show up on that night. Or I'm not a deacon, I'm not going to show up on that night. You need to be here every night. Amen? Amen. So, won't nobody have to tell you, amen, what was said. Amen. But you'll know for yourself. Amen? Amen. And then invite others out. Invite others out. Amen? Amen. We hope and pray that God will allow us to just teach. Amen? Hope and pray, dude. Amen? However, amen, we still got 3 days laying out there. Who knows what God can do tomorrow with 3 services? Amen? He may allow me to flip it into a revival. I don't know. After we get all the leg work out the way. Amen? After we get everything in its place. Then who knows, amen, what's going to come, amen, behind that. Amen? Amen. But I want you to understand, your coming will not be in vain. Amen. You will learn something, amen, on these 10 nights. Amen. You're going to see some things that you say, I thought I knew it. I thought I had it just right. But I see now. Glory to God. Amen. This should be our 25th convocation. It should be. Amen. The first year I started pastoring, in the first year I was pastoring, amen, we did our first convocation. Amen. And Mother Mitchell says to me, she says, son, you know what? Amen. You having the right time of year to. Amen. And she praised me for calling a convocation in, amen, March. Amen. God is good. Amen. And we've been trying to stick with it. When we first started out, we were inviting different churches to come and fellowship and speak. Glory to God. Amen. Talking about the meeting. Amen. But God says to me, amen, I praise God, man, I want you to take time. Amen. And run in the word of God to those that are going to be here. Amen. For tonight, perhaps no one will be here but my wife and I. Amen. We still going to run in the word of God. Amen. Amen. We're not going to cut it short because of the crowd, because of who's here and who's not here. Amen. But tonight, we're going to read just a little snippet. Amen. About, amen, what do convocation mean? Amen. And where did it arrive from? And then we're going to go home. That's all right. We're going to try to be as punctual as possible. Amen. I would love every night, 8:30, Amen. We're in our cars heading down the road. Wouldn't that be nice? Y'all doubt it? Y'all act just like my employees. When I tell them we get off at 4 o'clock, they look at each other. We're going to see. Amen? So I guess y'all said we're going to see. Amen? But you know what? If we show up here on time, have a good hot praise service. Oh, you all ain't saying nothing. I'm talking a good hot praise service. Amen. And I can get up. Amen. Amen. Around about 7:20, somewhere in there. We can be out of here. Hello, somebody. Because guess what? I have 10 nights to tell the story. So I don't have to try to tell it all in one sitting. Amen. God is good. So we're going to shoot for that. We're going to see, can we be like the other folks? Would that be all right?
Yeah.
Amen? But we got to be getting something. We don't want to just come and sit and go home. Hello, somebody. I want you to feel like that my inner man has been fed. Amen? I want you to reach out and grab it from the word when it first started. Amen. Don't sit back, chill, and relax and say, I'm going to get mine for 4 to 9. Because we don't intend to be here. Amen. But we do want God to have his way. Amen. We'll say what God wants to say. So if all possible, I understand those of you that have to work and you may get off a little late. I understand that. Amen. But those of you that don't have to work, come on to service. Come up and be here on time, before time. Amen. Selfie prayer around the altar. Get the altar hot. So when the praise leader get up, amen, the altar already been set. Prayers already went up. Amen. We can go into the amen, praise service. And amen, the musicians got the keys already warmed up and the strings ready to go. Amen. Have a good, hot, anointed praise service. Amen. We go into the teaching of the word. Amen. And God's going to move. God's going to bless. Amen. Well, Bishop, why should we get out 8:30? Amen? Well, for some, you are actually pressing your way, battling the sickness. And I'm expecting God to put an anointing upon me. Amen? And we're going to curse this thing once and for all by the root. Amen? 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 So we don't want to wear you out and wear you down, dragging out in the service. Amen? Holding you up, just be holding you up. Amen. Because I do know with rest, your body will heal itself. Amen. So that's what we're shooting for. And whatever we believe in God, that's going to happen. Amen. I believe it's my first year of pastoring. And I'm thinking it was this time of year. When I prayed for the whole flock and anybody, it was in March. Glory to God. Amen. It's time for your prescription to be refilled. Hello, somebody. Amen? Because it seems like the enemy have come immune to that anointing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. So God going to give us another anointing. A little stronger than that one was. Huh? Sickness ain't going to come nowhere around you. We're not just talking about a cold. We're talking about in general. Sickness going to have to go. Glory to God. And I want you to believe and trust God. Amen. In that service, on that night, amen, I want you to shout, I'm going to be delivered. Now, y'all ain't saying nothing. Now, remember, want somebody to hear that. I say, in that service, on that night, I want you to be able to shout, I've been delivered. I'm going to be delivered. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. Amen? But we're gonna read. Oh, just a little spouse, sir. We're gonna get out here. That's all right.
Yeah.
Amen. God is good. Amen. Talking about convocation. What does the Bible say about convocation? Richard?
Holy convocation. What does the Bible, Holy Convocation, say about convocation? Convocation, also referred to as set apart gathering, is the most widely used word to bring people, churches, Christian religious institutions, and synagogues in today's generation. It is said that the festival, we must gather, come together to worship. The aim of this study paper is to shed light on convocation, meaning in its correct context and its spiritual meaning for all true believers who live by the Torah laws of Eliyahu. Holy Convocation. The word convocation appears in the scriptures as follows. Word, the number of times it appears in the scriptures. Convocations, 15 times. In Hebrew, the word convocation.
It's two of them. The convocations, yes.
And then convocations. Three times,
okay.
In Hebrew, the word convocation means Michael, spoken as Michael. Strong's Concordance. Hebrew, this word means rehearsal. What does the word rehearsal mean? Rehearsal is defined practicing in preparation for an event.
Now, I'm a pause right there. Convocation. Amen. A gathering. Amen. A gathering of churches, synagogues, assemblies, all across the land. Amen. Coming together to practice. Amen. Or to worship. Amen. This time of year, once a year, amen, we coming together to rehearse or to practice our duties. Amen. To practice or rehearse, amen, what holiness or what the scriptures is all about. Amen. This is not just meeting as usual. Amen. But this gathering, amen, is for our learning. As I read the CSI, I notice that the Lord, Jehovah, amen, he says unto Moses on numerous times, amen, explain to the oncoming generation. Amen. Remind them of what happened. Amen. Why you all are keeping these days. Amen. A lot of time, people simply don't understand or have forgotten. Amen. Why they are holding their positions. They have forgotten, seems like. Amen. What they are here for. Amen. We're not just here to be coming and going home. Amen. But we're here with a purpose. There's no doubt in my heart. The call of God is upon so many of you all. Whether you have acknowledged it or hadn't. I've seen some growth in some since last year. Some growth that I'm very proud of. Amen. I feel like a very proud, proud pastor to see how some of you have grown. And at the same time, I feel like ducking my head and hiding when I see how some has turned out. However, we must be content with however God allowed it to be. Amen? But the word convocation, amen, simply means to rehearse. Help somebody. And the word rehearse me to practice. Amen. What's going to be said the next dying night, to be done the next dying night, amen, you need to hear it over and over again. Amen. It need to get in your system. It need to get within you so you will know. Amen. What Bible way and what the church or what holiness is all about. Amen. The answer after tonight is not going to be, I don't know. You're going to have an answer. Amen. but to practice. I don't care what type of sport it is, and I don't care what team it is. In order to be a champion, or in order to play a good game, you're going to have to practice. Amen? And they don't just practice one time. You'd be surprised how those athletes, they practice over and over and over. Their spare time, they are practicing. Amen? They are trying to make themselves better. And that's what this is about. Amen? That you can make yourself better in the Lord.
Amen?
Amen? When the question is asked, what will you have me to do? Amen? We should be equipped and prepared to do it. Not just saying it, but to do it. Amen? This is not a place of dissimulation. This is a place of togetherness. But we can't work together in togetherness if we don't know why we're here. Preacher?
In Hebrew, this word means to be set apart or to be holy, sanctified for God.
To be set apart, sanctified, holy for God. Everything going to be said this week, we're doing it at the request of God. Amen? At the request of God. Be here and see. Be here and see. You can get a word. I didn't know, Bishop, but I know now. I understand now. Be here and see. Preacher?
We can clearly understand that the word convocation is firstly to practice, secondly to read. And in a nutshell, we can say that the term convocation means to set apart an appointed time to Elohim and to read, understand his laws so that you can use his laws in your life. Practice them.
A lot of people don't really know. Hello? Amen? You're coming, but you really don't know. And we hope on these homecoming night days, amen, your understanding will be open. Amen? You will have say that I didn't raise my tuition. Huh? You're going to hear something that say that, you know, I am so glad if we were in school. I am so glad I took that class. Amen? I'll take it again. I've got so much out of it. Amen? We intend to impart to you as God imparts to us. Amen? But you're going to have to hear and start practicing. Amen? Your understanding got to be open. Amen? God is good. Amen. Amen. So we're going to come. We're going to be on time. Amen. Be punctual. Amen. We're going to get out of here. Amen. We're going to walk out the door. What time? Y'all forgot? 8:30. Amen. Now, I would tell Deacon Sutton to start killing the lights at 8:30, but I might not be through. God is good. Amen. I tell him all the time on the job. Little brother Jesse Underwood, he worked with us. He was Underwood, Pastor Underwood. They couldn't afford a daycare, but he probably could have afforded, but it was cheaper for us to babysit brother Jesse. So Jesse started working with Faith Construction, he was probably about 3-ish. Amen? Amen? And brother Jesse, amen, he grew up. I put a little seat in the back of the van for him to sit in with a seatbelt. So he grew up Faith Construction. He didn't know the name or nothing, but he knew what we wanted. And we just said, Jesse, go get me the thing to do this with. Here, go get the thing to do this with. Amen. Go get the thing to do this with, Jessica. Here, go get the thing to do that with. He didn't really know the names of them. But he knew a thing to do well with. And when it come like 2:30, 3 o'clock, especially service night, Jesse started putting them things back up. And we'd be hollering, Jesse, don't put them up. It's time to go. Jesse wouldn't see his mama and his sibling. And me and Underwood, we'd be hollering and screaming at him. He'd be just steady putting them things up. Tell us something. So, we all intend this. Amen. Do what we got to do. And we're going to try it on these 9 nights. Amen. And see how it rolls. All right. Amen. We thank God for you coming.